Okay, hi students, welcome to Write Unit 5. And Unit 5 is called I Had a Cold. So this unit is basically about sickness and symptoms. And you know, since the COVID pandemic is out on the loose, we have to learn the safety precautions and learn about the symptoms. So the writing task for today is write about the day you had a cold. Warm up. So, you have a headache. Have a headache. Have watery eyes. Have watery eyes. Have a runny nose. Have a runny nose. Have a cough. Have a cough. Have a fever. Have a fever. Have an earache. Have an earache. Have a hoarse voice. Have a hoarse voice. Have a sore throat. Have a sore throat. Number one. Do you often have a cold? Well, sometimes I have a cold, but it's not that bad. It's just sometimes, and you can cure, you know, very fast. Number two. How do you feel when you have a cold? I feel sick and I feel very tired and I don't want to leave my bed. Yes. Next, let's read about Jennifer's story. A cold. Last week, I had a cold and I felt very sick. I had a cough and a runny nose. I also had a high fever. On Friday, I missed school and went to see a doctor. I even got a shot for my cold. I had to lie in bed all day because of my cold. When I was sick, my mom stayed by my side. She made me some delicious food and I felt much better. I hope I don't get sick again. Question number one. What happened to Jennifer last week? So, looking at the back at the paragraph, she said, last week, she had a cold. So we are going to say, she had a cold last week. She had a cold last week. Number two, what did Jennifer's mom make for Jennifer? So looking at the paragraph, we can see that when I was sick, my mom stayed by my side. She made me some delicious food. So we are going to say, Jennifer's mom made Jennifer some delicious food. Jennifer's mom made Jennifer some delicious food. Moving on to writing basics 1. Look at the pictures. Complete the sentences using the phrases in the box. A headache. A headache. An earache. An earache. A cough. A cough. A fever, a fever. A sore throat, a sore throat. A hoarse voice, a hoarse voice. A runny nose, a runny nose. Watery eyes, watery eyes. So, number one, we can see that this dude right here is coughing. So we're gonna say, I had a cough. I had a cough. And this guy right here is having a very runny nose. So we're gonna say, I had a runny nose. I had a runny nose. Number three, she is having some problems with her neck. Must be the sore throat. So we will say, I had a sore throat. I had a sore throat. Number four. She is having a high fever. So we are going to say, I had a fever. I had a fever. Number five. He is holding his head, which means he is having a headache. So we are going to say, I had a headache. Number six. This guy is, coughing out. He's trying to speak, but look at how he speak. So we are gonna say, I had a hoarse voice. I had a hoarse voice. Number 7, she is holding her ear, which means she is painful. So we're gonna say, I had an earache. I had an earache. Number 8, she is holding her eyes. So we're gonna say, I had watery eyes. I had watery eyes. Moving on to writing basics 2. Circle the things you should do when you have a cold. Complete the sentences like the example. Remember to change the verb into past tense. So, go to see a doctor. Of course, when you are sick, you have to see the doctor. So, we're going to circle this. Get a shot. You know, get a vaccine shot or something. So, we're going to circle this too. Take my temperature. Yes, when you are sick, you have to take your temperature to see if you are normal or not. Go shopping. No. When you are sick, you cannot go shopping. And you cannot play outside too, so don't circle these. But when you are sick, you have to take some medicine, so you have to circle this. And you have to stay in bed and drink a lot of water. So number 1, I went to see a doctor. I went to see a doctor. Number 2, I got a shot. I got a shot. Number 3, I took my temperature. I took my temperature. Number 4, I took some medicine. I took some medicine. Number 5, I stayed in bed. I stayed in bed. Number 6, I drank a lot of water. I drank a lot of water. Moving on to writing practice 1. Look at the example. Write the sentences in the same way. Lie in bed all day, cold. I had to lie in bed all day because of my cold. I had to lie in bed all day because of my cold. Stay home all afternoon, cold. I had to stay at home all afternoon because of my cold. I had to stay home all afternoon because of my cold. Number 3. Go to the hospital. Cough. I had to go to the hospital because of my cough. I had to go to the hospital because of my cough. 4. Take some pills. Headache. I had to take some pills because of my headache. I had to take some pills because of my headache. Number 5. Skip dinner. Stomachache. I had to skip dinner because of my stomachache. I had to skip dinner because of my stomachache. How did you feel when you were sick? Sick. Complete the sentences using the words in the box. Weak. Weak. Sleepy. Sleepy. Tired. Tired. Angry. Angry. Sick. Sick. Funny. Funny. Strange. Strange. Sad. Sad. I had a cold and I felt sick. I had a cold and I felt sick. So when I have a fever, I feel sleepy. I had a fever and I feel sleepy. Because you don't want to do anything. You just want to stay in bed and you sleep, right? I had a headache. And I feel weak. I had a headache and I feel weak. Oh, it's I felt weak, not I feel. Because, you know, the difference between feel and felt is that feel is V-O or V-1, like the simple tense. But felt is V-2, so you have to use felt. because had right here is V2. So let's say again. I had a cold and I felt sick. I had a fever and I felt sleepy. I had a headache and I felt weak. I had a hoarse voice and I felt sad. I had a hoarse voice and I felt sad. Because when you talk, everybody is just gonna make fun of you because of how different your voice is. Number 5. I had a runny nose and I felt strange. I had a runny nose and I felt strange. Moving on to writing practice 2. Look at the example. Write the sentences in the same way. Remember to change the verb into past tense. My mom make delicious food. My mom made me delicious food. My mom made me delicious food. My mom make some soup. My mom made me some soup. My mom made me some soup. My dad make hot chocolate. My dad made me hot chocolate. My dad made me hot chocolate. The doctor gave a shot. The doctor gave me a shot. The doctor gave me a shot. 4. The pharmacist gave some medicine. The pharmacist gave me some medicine. The pharmacist gave me some medicine. Correct the mistakes and rewrite the sentences. Last week, I have a cold and I felt very sick. Last week is past tense, so we cannot use have. We have to use had. So we're gonna say, last week I had a cold and I felt very sick. Last week I had a cold and I felt very sick. When I sick, my mom stayed by my side. It must be when I'm sick, not when I sick. So we're gonna say, when I'm sick, my mom stayed by my side. When I'm sick, my mom stayed by my side. Number 3. I felt many better. Your feelings cannot be counted, so we can't use many, but we have to use much. So we are gonna say, I felt much better. I felt much better. I hope I don't got sick again. Don't is a simple tense, not past tense, so we have to use get. I hoped I don't get sick again. I hoped I don't get sick again. Moving on to organizing. Look at the example and organize your writing. Cold, symptoms, cough, runny nose, high fever. What I did, missed school, went to see a doctor, got a shot, had to lie in bed all day. What my mom did for me, stayed by my side, made me some delicious food. So I'm gonna talk about when I'm cold. Symptoms, I will cough, of course, and when I'm cold, I will usually feel, very tired, cough and tired, and especially I feel sleepy. Yes, because it's just a small cold. What I did, I missed school, of course, and I went to see a doctor. I took some medicine and I had to lie in bed all day. And my mom took care for me. So my mom did for me is that she stayed by my side and she cooked me some chicken soup. Oh, more expressions. What I did for my cold, kept warm, took some cough syrup, stayed indoors, went to bed early. What my mom or dad did for me, read me books, made me chicken soup, took me to the hospital, stayed home with me. Moving on to drafting. Complete your story, use your notes from page 44. I had a cold. Okay, so I'm just gonna describe my paragraph. You guys can describe what you felt when you had a cold. But this is what I felt when I had a cold. I took my note from page 44. Let's go. Title, I had a cough. No, I had a cold, not cough. Introduction, last week I had a cold and I feel very tired. I had to skip school. I also had to lie in bed all day and went to the doctor. I felt very tired. I for my cold. So you have to do something for your cold, right? You know, I kept warm for my cold. I had to skip school because of my cold. I had to, you know, eat porridge for my cold. Eat warm food for my cold. You guys can use many, many ideas. Paragraph 3. What someone did for you. When I was sick. When you were sick, you are gonna say your symptoms, right? But this is someone. When you were sick, someone will take care of you, and that person is my mom. When I was sick, my mom took care, great care of me. She stayed by my side, and I was, you know, she cooked me some delicious food. She cooked me some delicious food. She stayed by my side, and I felt much better. And in conclusion, you can say, I hope I will never get sick again, or I hope I will get better soon. It's up to you whether you are out of your sickness or you are still learning this in sickness. It depends. Writing tip. Transition words. Time. Transition words and phrases can be used to show time order. These time order words help the reader understand what happened first and what happened next. Here are some examples. After, as soon as, at first, at last, soon, later, then, before. So, thank you for joining in to today's lesson. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Sorry for not uploading in a long time because I was busy with my studies and research. So, I will try to upload more contents in the future. So if you guys enjoyed, please subscribe. That would be greatly appreciated. And I'll see you guys in the next video, I guess. Bye.